So in this lecture, mainly we'll discuss the classification of signal, and we already discussed some of the classification of signal. Now, in this particular lecture, we'll discuss the periodicity property, that is periodic and non-periodic signals. Okay, and we'll discuss the definition of periodic and non-periodic signal and basic equations required to solve the problems. And we'll also derive some equations, standard equations. And we'll discuss that also, some numerical questions. So for a signal is said to be periodic, for any signal x of t is said to be periodic, it should satisfy this condition: x of t plus t is equal to x of t. So after a particular time, the signal repeats its value. Okay, that's the meaning. And by using this mathematical formula, you can see that the signal values are, or signal amplitude is equal. A continuous wave signal x of t is said to be periodic with period t, okay, capital T, if there is a positive non-zero value of t for which it satisfies this particular condition. So for check the periodicity, we will use this particular equation. We can explain the concept with the help of an example. So here you can see one signal which is x of t, and here the time period, the x-axis is t. And if you look at this particular waveform, this time t is equal to 0.1, okay, and this particular time the signal amplitude is 1. You can see that after a particular time, let be this duration, okay, this duration is actually 0.2 seconds. So after 0.2 seconds, you can see that the function is having exactly same value, 1. Okay, so we can say that signal value repeats after 0.2 seconds. Or if you closely observe the other point, at 0.2, at t is equal to 0.2, the signal magnitude is actually -1. So here the signal amplitude is -1. Okay, so after 0.2 seconds from that particular point, okay, we can see that 0.4, the signal value repeats. So we can say that this particular signal repeats after 0.2 second. Okay. And I'll take another example. If you take this value 0.1, at t is equal to 0.1, the signal amplitude is 1. After 0.4 seconds, after 0.5 seconds, after 0.4 seconds, you will reach at 0.5. Okay. You can see that again the signal amplitude is 1. Similarly, after 0.5 second, the signal value at 0.7, you are getting again the same amplitude. So the signal amplitude is repeating after a regular interval of time. Okay. So we can see that the signal at x of t, so assume that this is x of t and this is x of t plus 0.2. You are getting exactly the same value. So we can say that signal repeat after 0.2 seconds. So in this particular example, you can say that t is 0.2. So this is the periodicity concept. And you can define one more term that is known as a fundamental period. It's very important. Fundamental period T0 is the smallest positive value of t that satisfy x of t plus t is equal to x of t. Or in a general form, you can write the signal repeats 0.2 seconds, or I can say it repeats 0.4 seconds, or you can say 0.6 seconds. If you closely observe that after this value, okay, this is actually x of t. If this is t1, for example, this is t1 plus 0.2, assume that this is t1 and t1 plus 0.4 seconds. Okay, you'll reach at this particular point. So either you can say the signal repeat after 0.2 seconds or you can say signal repeat after 0.4 seconds. So if you compare these two things, you can rearrange this equation x of t1 plus 2 into 0.2 seconds. So this 0.2 is the minimum repeating time. So that repeating time is known as the fundamental period t0. Okay. And this fundamental period t0, you can also define in terms of frequency, that is fundamental frequency f0, and which is written as 1 by t0. So frequency is 1 by t, and the unit of this particular frequency is hertz. So we'll write hertz, or we can say it's cycles per second. So either you can define this fundamental period in terms of seconds t0 or in terms of f0. We can also use the term or the frequency in radians per second, or we can call it as an angular frequency. It's simply the modified representation of this fundamental frequency f0. So angular frequency is defined as omega 0 is equal to 2 pi into f0. So f0 is 1 by t0. So either you can write 2 pi into f0 or 2 pi by t0. So this unit, this frequency unit is hertz, and the angular frequency unit is radians per second. Okay. So now we'll discuss the same concept for a discrete time signal. A discrete time sequence x of n is said to be periodic with period n if there is a positive integer n for which it satisfies x of n plus n is equal to x of n for all. So if you look at this particular diagram, you can see that 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, sorry, 1, 2, 3, sorry, 2, 3, this is 4, and this is 5, and 6, 7, 8. You can see after 8 samples, it's again repeats the pattern. Okay, the same positive value repeats. So in this particular example, we can say that n value is equal to 8. After 8 samples, the signal repeats its value. Okay, the same thing is applicable if you start from this point also. If you look at from this particular point, again, you can see the signal repeat after 8 samples. So in this particular discrete time signal, we can say that this particular signal is periodic. But we can see another example, which is a non-periodic signal. Here it is n. You can assume that this is something like this. There is no repeating pattern. So this is not a periodic signal. So we can call it as a non-periodic signal, or we can also call it as an aperiodic signal. Okay. Either we can call it as a non-periodic or aperiodic signal. So this is an example for an aperiodic signal, which does not repeat after a regular interval time. Another important point, for a continuous time signal, this t can take any value, any fractional value. But in the case of discrete time signal, the capital N is always an integer. Okay. Because discrete time signal, there is no signal values are defined only at discrete interval of time, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. So the fundamental period is always an integer. It's very important. The fundamental period capital N is always an integer. You can also write the generalized formula. Either you can say in this particular example, the signal repeats after 8 samples, or we can say the 16 samples or 32 samples, etc. So you can write the general form x of n plus mn. And the smallest value of n for which it satisfies this particular condition is known as a fundamental period n0. Okay. Here also, you can define the angular frequency and all. Usually in textbooks, the angular frequency in a discrete time signal, sometimes they will use another representation, that is ohm. Or you can use omega zero also. Okay. In some textbook, they will follow this pattern to define the angular frequency discrete time signal by using omega zero. So now we need to find the fundamental period and fundamental frequency of this wave and express the fundamental frequency in units of hertz and radians per second. So if you closely observe this particular signal, we can see that this particular signal is a periodic signal. And the fundamental period of this particular waveform, if you closely observe that, it repeats after 0.2 seconds. Okay, so the minimum time period, that is T0, or we can call it as a fundamental period of this particular signal x of t, that is t is equal to 0.2 seconds. And we need to represent in the frequency, fundamental frequency. So fundamental frequency f0, that is in hertz, I can define 1 by t0. So it becomes 1 by 0.2. So 1 by 0.2 seconds means it's 5 hertz. So this is the unit of frequency. And now we also need to represent in radians per second. So fundamental frequency radians per second means it's an angular frequency representation. So this is the angular frequency. So this is angular frequency omega zero, which we can return as 2 pi into f0. So we can write 2 pi into 5. So it's 10 pi and the unit is radians per second. Okay. So the same quantity I can represent in different form. One is T0, okay, that is fundamental period in seconds. Another is frequency f in hertz, or you can represent the angular frequency omega 0, that is 2 pi f 0. This is 2 pi into 5, which is equal to pi 10 pi radians per second. Okay. Now we can take a standard signal. It's a fundamental period of the continuous time sinusoidal signal. First thing you should know about that, all the continuous time, okay, it's very important. This is for continuous time. For all the continuous time sinusoidal signals are periodic. Okay, this is one important point you need to remember. Okay, all the continuous time sinusoidal signals are periodic. And now we need to find the period of this particular sinusoidal signal. So we need to verify this periodicity. So the condition is x of t is equal to x of t plus t. And in this particular question, x of t is given. So in place of t, you need to substitute t plus t. So you can write a sine omega in place of t, you need to substitute t plus t, okay, plus theta. And if you rearrange this, you will get a sine omega t plus omega t plus theta. And again, if you rearrange and group the terms, sine omega t plus theta plus omega t. Okay, if you look at this particular equation with x of t, these two equations should be equal. Means we know that this is the term which is available in x of t, because x of t is simply a sine omega t plus theta. Okay, and these two equations are equal when omega t is equal to zero, or you can say the sine values are repeating after or every 2 pi angle. So I can write like this, omega t is non-zero value, you can write it's 2 pi or multiples of 2 pi. Okay, so the fundamental period t or T0 can be written as either you can write 2 pi by omega. So M can take the minimum value 1. So you can write T0 is equal to 2 pi by omega. And this is the standard equation to find the fundamental period. And you should look at this particular standard representation. Here the amplitude of the signal is A. And when you find the final equation T0, there is no term called A. And there is a phase shift theta But at the final equation, there is no importance for theta. Means it's a sinusoidal signal. So if you change the theta, you will get cos. So you can use the same formula for calculating a sine or cos. Okay, that's another important point. The same formula you can use for a sinusoidal signal, so sine or cosine signals. And it only depends on the factor omega, which is associated with the t. And you need to consider this particular term, and 2 pi by omega. So the fundamental period depends only the term omega. So this is a standard equation to find the fundamental frequency of a continuous time periodic signal. Okay, a continuous time sinusoidal signal is always periodic with fundamental period t0 is equal to pi by omega. Now we'll discuss an exponential signal. It's a complex exponential signal of the form a e raised to j omega t. Again, we need to verify the periodicity condition by using the formula x of t is equal to x of t plus t. So we need to find the fundamental period t or t0. Okay. In this particular formula, you can substitute e raised to j omega. In place of t, you can substitute t plus t. And if you rearrange, you will get e raised to j omega t into e raised to j omega capital T. And this equation should be equal to x of t, where x of t is equal to a e raised to j omega t. Sorry, a e raised to j omega t small t. And if you compare these two equations, there is an extra term, and this term should be equal to 1. Then we can say that x of t and x of t plus t are equal. Okay. Now, e raised to j omega t, by using Euler's formula, you can write cos omega t plus j sine omega t. Okay. And this e raised to j omega t should be equal to 1, means there is no imaginary term, so this term should be equal to 0. And the sine value is equal to 0 for 0 or 2 pi. So we can write omega t is an integer multiples of 2 pi. So you can write the fundamental period t0, it's simply 2 pi by omega. And you will get exactly the same equation as in the case of a sinusoidal signal. Here you can see that if the term is, the amplitude is a, there is no importance for this amplitude in the final equation. It simply depends on the term omega. So we are using the same equation for sinusoidal signal and the complex exponential signal. Now we'll discuss the fundamental period of discrete time sinusoidal signal. And here is very important that this is a discrete time signal. Okay. And here we cannot say that all the sinusoidal discrete time sinusoidal signals are periodic. It is periodic only if that fundamental period is an integer value. So we cannot write like this, always periodic. There is a restriction. It's periodic if it is satisfies some particular condition. The condition we can derive. So we need to derive some condition. But in the case of continuous time signal, the sinusoidal signals are always periodic. So again, you can apply the condition here, x of n is equal to x of n plus n. So we need to find n plus n. So a sine, in place of n, you can substitute n plus n plus theta. So if you rearrange, you will get a sine omega n plus omega capital N plus theta. And if you group this particular term, a sine omega n plus theta plus omega capital N. Okay. And if you compare with x of n is equal to a sine omega n plus theta. Okay. So you can see that this term, omega into capital N. And so we know that if it is a sinusoidal signal, it's a periodic, discrete time sinusoidal signals are periodic with a fundamental period, with period 2 pi and m into 2 pi, integer multiples of 2 pi. So you can write omega n is equal to m into 2 pi. But the fundamental period n0, you can write m into 2 pi by omega. But there is a problem in the case of discrete time signal if you use this particular equation. In the previous case, we substituted m is equal to 0 in the case m is equal to 1 in the case of continuous time signal. But in the case of discrete time signal, we know that the n should be an integer value. So this quantity should be an integer. Okay. So we need to substitute different values for m, integer values for m, and for smallest value of m, you will get n integer. If you get n is equal to integer, then the signal is periodic. Or we can say that signal is periodic only if this n by m is a rational number. Okay, so we can conclude that this discrete time sinusoidal signal is periodic only if this n by m is a rational number. So that is a condition of periodicity, and the frequency formula or the fundamental period we can calculate by using this particular formula, n0 is equal to m into 2 pi by omega. It only depends on the frequency component, and there is no importance for this a and theta. This formula is almost similar to continuous time signal, but there is one condition: this n0 is always an integer. This condition is not required in the case of continuous time signal. Now we can discuss the discrete time complex exponential signal. So again, you can check the condition x of n plus n. Okay, so a e raised to j omega in place of n, you can substitute n plus capital N. And if you simply modify this equation, you can write e raised to j omega n into e raised to j omega capital N. And if we compare with x of n, which is equal to a e raised to j omega n, and here there is a term called e raised to j omega capital N that should be equal to 1, then only you can write x of n plus n is equal to x of n. So this e raised to j omega n, by using Euler's formula, you can write cos omega n plus j sine omega n, and this should be equal to 1. So this is a real quantity, so this portion should be equal to 0. So for that, this sinusoidal part or the sine value, sine angle omega n, should be an integer multiples of 2 pi. Again, you can write the fundamental period n0 is equal to m into 2 pi by omega. And again, it's a discrete time signal. For a discrete time signal, this should be an integer. So we need to verify different values for m. And the smallest value of m for which we are getting this particular quantity as an integer, then we can say the signal is periodic and the fundamental period is n0 is equal to m 2 pi by omega. Again, there is a condition: this n0 by m should be a rational number. Then only signal is periodic and the period is n0 is equal to m into 2 pi by omega. Okay, so this is the standard formula for calculating the fundamental period of discrete time complex exponential signal.